Hello, my friends. Welcome back to the adventures of Redguard Sword Singer, Nazeem Al-Ashabah. Today we will be traveling from Wayrest back to the kingdom of Daggerfall and the city of Daggerfall, for we are on a mission to get more information about the Emperor's missing letter. You'll notice that we have an improved map here. I am now using Daggerfall Unity version 1.0, which was recently released, and I am also using the latest version of the Dream mod. So there will be some improvements here and there. Let's go ahead and travel cautiously by ship. That sounds great. A young lad with the rose of Wayrest embroidered on his surcoat appears at your side, hands you an engraved card, and disappears. Well, that's interesting. Let's go ahead and read that. King Eadweir and Queen Berenzaya, sovereigns of the Kingdom of Wayrest, are proud to announce the engagement of Morgaya, Princess of Wayrest, to Carudil, King of Firsthold in the Isle of Somerset. Well, we had a hand in facilitating that. And Morgaya, in exchange, gave us some details about the Emperor's missing letter. Apparently it's in the hands of an orc warlord named Gortwog. But to get more information, we should try to get in the good graces of the Queen Mother to Gothrid, and we were instructed not to approach her directly. That might attract too much attention, might even be downright dangerous. So we shall start with someone of lower station and see where we can get. Castle Daggerfall. Yes, we agree. And here we are. I think for now, we will not bother speaking with the king and queen themselves. Let's chat with some of these folks. I despise your kind. Just go away. Oh, lovely. And how about you, madam? Lady Bridwell? Good day. Hail, good Lady Bridwell. What is on the tongue of polite society these days? Firsthold has a new queen, and Wayrest has lost a princess. Yes, I suppose so. Let's see, how would I even pursue more information here? There might not be any way for me to try to get more specific rumors. And that would be dangerous anyway. I can't be too blunt with any of these people. Let me just speak with a few more of these noble folk and see if any opportunities present themselves. I assume you're a bard? I've heard of you. Nothing good, of course. Get lost. Not very nice, some of these people. What do you want? Lord Provlith? Fair day to thee. Indulge me in a little gossip, if you would. Princess Morgaya has left Wayrest for Somerset Isle and the King of Firsthold. And you, madam, Barbana Mooring? What do you want? Hail, Barbana Mooring. Would you kindly update me on the world at large? Morgaya will be the first Queen of Firsthold who isn't a high elf. Wow, that is pretty neat. She is still of elven kind, of course, but the clatter of pots and pans and the smell of fresh-baked bread waft through this door. Okay. Let us chat with this lady. I could use your help, Nazeem Al-Ashabah, but you just ain't tough enough to handle what I gotta have done. You get better and then come see me. Okay. I've got a feeling that she is the one who can provide a useful quest line in pursuit of the Emperor's letter. In the meantime, let's get some more experience by perhaps completing a quest for one of these two. What is it? Hail, good King Gothrid. You haven't heard anything interesting lately, have you? Her wayrest has cemented relations with the High Elves of Firsthold by marriage. And you, good Queen Aubk-i? My husband's poor grandmother, Nulfaga, is rumored to be in very frail health, her once brilliant mind almost utterly destroyed. She has locked herself in her castle in the Wrothgarian Mountains, and experiments in magical studies with no regard for her own safety. I would know of her condition, but few possess the bravery to face the horrors of her castle and speak with her. My reward for a report on her health is a magical tall boots. Will you be my champion in this? Yes, sure. By the Dwarf King, I am glad to have found a champion. The name of her castle is Shedungent, and it should not take you longer than 150 days to go there and return. If she is insane, Shedungent may be a very dangerous place indeed. Be very careful. May Kinnereth and Mara protect you. Thank you, good queen. I shall not fail you. Now then. How can I help you, stranger? Why has the queen developed this sudden affection for crazy old Nulfaga? I believe you are speaking of your grandmother, King Gothrid. Perhaps you could speak with a bit more respect. Well, let's go ahead and see what we can find in the Wrothgarian Mountains. So that would be way over here. Okay. Shedungent. Hold on. So I think it's over in this section. I'm just curious to see exactly where it's located. Okay. We'll go recklessly. You notice a strong, acrid odor. Interesting. Oh my. I think the Dynamic Skies mod has failed me. There we go. It does have some funny moments now and then. Now, I should say I am actually using version 1.2. It's an older version of that mod. And that's because the newer versions, for some reason, don't have the HD versions of these two moons that we can barely see here ahead of us, Master and Secunda. So, to get those HD graphics, we are using the older version. Let's go ahead and survey this situation a little bit more. Are there any other entrances? So anyway, if there is some buggy behavior from the Dynamic Skies mod, I don't want to lay too much blame on the feet of the mod creators, because again, I'm using an older version, and hopefully they will have an updated version of the new version of their mod that will include the HD textures at some point. No other entrances. Let us carefully rappel down. And rest up. You have no idea what to expect here. So let us be cautious. Do not like the sounds we're hearing, nor the general atmosphere here. It does not seem particularly welcoming. some fighting taking place. We shall let them continue fighting. Whom do we have here? Some sort of mage. Be you friend or foe? Greetings. Foe it is then. I forgot to cast a mark spell, or a recall anchor, whatever it should be called, in this game. There we go. Got a nice anchor here. Beautiful. Now we'll take a look at what remains here. A magically held lock. Let us magically open it. Or not magically. Not sure if that'll work. Lock is too powerful. Okay. Perhaps we'll find another way into that room. I should also mention, I decided to follow the current practice of the creator of the Dream mod of not including the hand-painted models mod anymore. And I think I'm fine with it. I think I do like the idea of just, for the most part, just sticking with the overall style of the original game. You know, where they use 2D sprites, I'm content to see 2D sprites as well, for now. I think a lot of those nice mods that add 3D models, some of them could use a little more work and, you know, for additional completeness in terms of what they replace. And also, sometimes they do introduce a little more potential for bugginess. That hand-painted models mod in particular, I have experienced times when treasure piles that should exist in a certain spot are nowhere to be found, like they somehow sunk down into the floor or something like that. So I want to avoid that if I can. There are many reasons why sometimes the fewer mods, the better. Potion of levitation, that's nice. Whom do we have here? Another mage. Interesting gate. How might we open that? Could be a lever far away or very close at hand, for all we know. Was that? I saw some kind of sprite clipping through the wall there. Hello. Or perhaps I should say, no clipping through it. Sometimes that terminology is a bit confusing. Let's go ahead and take note of where we are. And head back to the entrance. Onto some of these potions, just in case. Let's try this direction this time. Seem to have a floating candle. Oh my. A mage. There are many of them here. That's Nulfaga in her insane experimentations. Has attracted quite a following. Wonder if she's even almost on the verge of founding her own cult. Who knows? Either that or it's just a collection of various power-hungry mages who simply want to take advantage of what her castle here offers for their own goals. Hello there. Go ahead and cast her spells. Whoa. Okay, maybe I shouldn't be quite so fast to speak that way. You two made a huge mistake, challenging a sword singer like myself. It does not look entirely friendly. Oh my. Oh, I have to reset the anchor. I forgot all about that. Okay then. I wonder if this is just how the original game was, or if something funky has happened here. Curious to see what's going on down in that deep rift. These mages do not seem particularly friendly. Go this way a bit. That looks interesting. A roaring fire, perhaps. Maybe just a bright lamp. A little tempting to shift to bow and arrow, but in terms of accurately role-playing my character, I want to give every enemy a chance to not be an enemy. I feel these graphics really do an excellent job of sort of conveying the atmosphere, how it would feel to be in a dank dungeon such as this. The lock has nothing to fear for me, eh? Gotcha. suppose I shouldn't try to gather too much of the stuff that doesn't have that much value. Oh no. Three different switches, huh? Okay, of course the insane Nulfaga has to make this complicated. Well, that has raised this gate. Where are we? I'm not sure whether I should flip the other switches or not. I probably might as well. For all I know, those might just... Ooh, that one hurt me. Only 3 points of health. And that third one, I have no idea what it may have done. But hopefully it opened another gate. Maybe this one. Okay. From now on, I'm not going to gather too much of the really mundane loot. Iron and chain and so forth. Probably even steel, I shouldn't bother with too much. Nazeem is not particularly desperate to make money or anything like that. Ugly. Another candle that seems to be floating. I hear strange noises in the distance. Would it be wise to flip this switch? Who knows what I have just done? Here we have one more switch back here. Oh my, a mysterious portal. I'll try this switch. No idea what that did. And now, for a true test of Nazeem's courage. We shall plunge through this portal. Does not seem to be admitting us. Okay then. I'm not sure whether it's more likely that Nulfaga will be down in lower portions of the castle or up in the higher chambers. Difficult to say. And to be honest, I don't think I ever really made it this far in the main quest before. Hard to remember for sure, but I don't know if I ever actually chatted with Nulfaga. And that's not even very far when it comes to the main quest, I know. But yeah, I really had only played a little bit of this game back in the day, and I guess I may have focused a bit more on side quests. But it's fun to be able to finally experience more of it. Now with fewer bugs, greater graphical fidelity, and so forth. Let's see, well, yeah, let's go in the other direction. Okay. So this connects us with another area where we have been. Aha. That's not good. Gotcha. Are we now down in that rift I saw? Probably. Yeah, it looks like it. Well, we're gonna go ahead and put our bow to good use. Is that not working? Okay, very strange. There we go. I'll take care of you from a distance. Gotcha. Gotcha. Battle Mage. That was not what I meant to do. Thank you. I need to remember to douse my torches and candles when I'm resting. The long-lost location of the cave of Sahabrathaya. Cool. So long, battle mage. Elven Daikatana, that's cool. No, that's not good. Been a while since my character died. Well, let's go ahead and reload. Chairs stacked on top of each other. Puts me in mind of the sixth house, although, of course, in this case, there's a lot more order to their placement. Thank you. Okay, I've been here before, but not on this side of that gate. This whole place is deeply unsettling. Gotcha. Ivory. Hello. Gotcha. The location of the Balinxa hole. Interesting. We have a secret door here. Go down or up? That is often the question. Interesting room. Seems to be a small library of sorts. I'm a bit frightened to try any of these chairs. Well, I don't think that did anything, but who knows. I did hear a noise, but that could have been random. I think. secret door. Okay. So we're back here. Let's cast a light spell. Give ourselves a floating candle. So I guess I still have not explored this particular rift, but before, oh boy, here we go. Gotcha. Uh-oh, we're not feeling good. A map to the King Croft burial ground, okay. And we picked up this recipe for a potion of chameleon. How do we read that? Green leaves, yellow flowers, red berries, rainwater, nectar. Okay. Greetings. Poisoned. That is not good. We've used up a lot of our magic. This is not good. Somewhat bad. So I think if we rest, we might die. Might as well see if we can rest for 1 hour, see if we'll survive that. Oh? Pure poison costs quite a bit. Okay. Cure poison. Well, let's double check our status here. That's lowered our willpower, apparently. Now we're back to normal. Okay, that wasn't too bad. an enchanted vest. I suppose it is time to go down into this rift. Carefully. Silver claymore. Let's go back again. Drop off some things. Perhaps I'll go to the right again. So far, I haven't found an alternative way to get into this room. So we have a locked secret door. There we go. Come get me. See my candle? See my candle? Thank you. Not much else to this place, it seems. Not the most appealing statue. Okay. You mages are no match for me. Ah, we've leveled up. 5 points, not bad. to place these. More willpower actually sounds good. So now we're at level 4. Secret door. Oh my. Whoops. Okay, I've been here before. I like to try activating pretty much everything because you never know what might be a secret switch. Now where? Okay, so maybe I have explored most of this section. think I already activated that, didn't I? Probably. I think so, but... Where to go now? Where are you, Nulfaga? You're quite elusive. Oh yeah, here's this strange pile of refuse. So... Alright. Straight ahead and to the right. Where is Nulfaga? Come on. Suppose I should head over there. This section or that one. Or over there. I suppose there's an area here too. Multiple interesting avenues. Go back to the beginning again. Ah, I forgot to set an anchor. Hopefully, that will not be a huge problem. Hmm. Here we go. Why does that keep happening? When I try to sprint, sometimes I seem to slow down. I just stop all of a sudden. My elven katana is slightly used. The rest of my equipment seems fine. I do have my ebony dagger I can fall back on if need be. I wish I could get through this door. Lock is too powerful. What's going on in there? Come on, why don't one of you open this door? Nice. I see. Let's go back this way. First, we'll try this path. Hmm. mind. An interesting hallway. Potion of Chameleon form. Interesting. Oh my, what was that? Snuck up behind me, did you? Hmm. remember those dragon scales. Okay. Okay. Now then. Perhaps I should go there. That's all of them. Back to the beginning. Let's go back here. Try that again. Here we go. No longer. But now where? Hard to say, but I have a feeling maybe down into the depths again might be good. I think there are areas there I haven't explored yet.
Okay.
I just accidentally found a new area. Excellent. There was a door back around here, but it still had not opened. Okay. Glad to see that gate opened. And we've been here before. Pretty sure I hadn't moved that switch before. Not 100% sure. Okay then. Let's go down into the chasm. there's definitely some paths here that we had not explored before. Oh my. Good. Not good at all. Oh, that wasn't quite right. That boat's behind me now too. Nazeem doesn't use offensive magic too often. That attempt at a fireball was rather awkward, but he shall get better. Is there more to see here? Where could that Nulfaga be? Thank you. maybe this tunnel right there. Suppose there's a place, a couple of places there that have yet to be explored. Okay. Okay. Interesting. This way. Takes a while to switch weapons. Gotcha. Oh my. So what did that do? There is a great example of a seemingly innocent torch being a major switch. So hopefully it's good that I'm activating all of these. Elven Flail. Oh my. Perhaps I closed off my own path. Must be cautious not to fall prey to any traps. Of course, our main form of caution is safe scumming in games like this, and I have no problem with that. That's just the way it goes. It's nice to be able to take advantage of that. If only real life were so easy. It'd be nice to be able to go back to a previous safe state sometimes in life, wouldn't it? Try out different choices. Let things progress in various different ways. Well, there may be a door here that I've missed. Let us rest here. Nulfaga, Nulfaga, where on earth are you? Very interesting. Well, now where to? Maybe down there. Yes, indeed. This way. Three switches once again. Oh boy. And what do we have here? I don't like the look of that. Is that just a skeleton or a lich? Greetings. Interesting decor you guys have here. Command me, and entry shall be yours. Oh my goodness, I have no idea what to say to this guy. Open. Magically held lock. Ah, we're back there. Ha! Nice. So we did finally gain entry to this room. Very interesting. What are you all about, huh? Sir Skellington? What's your story? Well, we have some rooms to explore. So here you are, Nulfaga herself. United thoughts and counsels, equal hope and hazard in the once glorious enterprise joined with me once, now misery has joined in equal ruin. Eternal, eternal, eternal ruin. I tell the door to my soul to shut up. Oh, my child, why wouldst thou not listen? Thy ear, thy glorious mortal face, thy throat and the arrow. Oh, misery. Fascinating. What does all that mean? Well, perhaps those words can offer some clue as to what befell Lysandus. Perhaps someone else can help us fully interpret her words. That was definitely interesting. Those things she said about throat and arrow and so forth. Well, Aubk-i, the Queen of Daggerfall, has asked me to check on the condition of her grandmother-in-law, Nulfaga. I am to go to Nulfaga's castle, Shedungent of Wrothgaria, and talk to her to see if she is well. I have 127 days to report the condition to Aubk-i and get my reward. Well, Eternal. Arrow. Ruin. I have no idea. What are these doors opening? Something might be going on back here. Well, I'm glad we finally found her. I suppose we might as well teleport back to the entrance and get out of here. The ground vibrates underfoot. Almost 6 p.m. I suppose there's nothing further for us to do here, at least not for now. You know, I have a vague recollection that there should have been a dragon companion next to Nulfaga. Or am I thinking of a different part of the game? Again, I'm not very familiar with the main quest, but I feel like I've seen pictures of that. In fact, there's a mod to restore a low-poly model of the dragon that was in the original game files, but that didn't make it into the original version of the game in terms of the way it was at release. But those files were still within the game, but they just weren't being used in the game as you play it. Anyway, let's go ahead and travel back to Daggerfall. Recklessly will be much faster. That was not a good idea. Being around here at night can be very perilous. Lysandus, we have recently spoken with your mother. She had some confusing and troubling words to share. Better get a little further away from the city. Who do you think you are? You not know who you're dealing with. Knight. Werewolf. Or werebore. This could be a fearsome foe. Got him. Nazeem is truly becoming powerful. It's very nice to see. Uh-oh. Have we encountered a bug? Seem to be frozen up. As we entered Daggerfall. Good thing we saved very recently. Yeah, it seems to be completely locked up. Can't even open up the terminal. So we better relaunch. And now, we face the werebor again. Rest up a little bit. And quick save again. Hope for the best. Okay, no problem this time. I'll take care of selling things later, off-camera. No need to ever bore you guys again with those kinds of mundane details. For now, let's head straight back to the castle. Yes, yes. Greetings all. I bring some strange tidings from Nulfaga. Hello, King. How can I help you, stranger? Stranger? Come on. Sentinel got the short end of the stick in some deal. Now they're out to get mixers of Dibella. Have a key. I confess I doubted I would ever see you again. Your news that Nulfaga is still among the living does my heart much good. Here is your tall boots. Okay. Well, that is something. Nazeem, I do not know even how to broach this subject. I need you to promise me, on your ancestors' honor, that you will do what you can to help me and never breathe of what I say or what you see to anyone else, anywhere. Will you so swear? Yes. I will trust you then, Nazeem. The matter concerns my mother-in-law, the Dowager Queen of Daggerfall and widow of Lysandus, Minnesera. As mistress of the household finances, I have noticed that she has been paying for the upkeep of a fortress called Castle Necromogon, complete with a large platoon of soldiers. A short while ago, she disappeared with a wrapped parcel of papers and came back days later with empty hands. She has recently left again with another parcel of letters, and my spies have verified that she has gone to Castle Necromogon. You will have to trust that my suspicion of her activities is justifiable, for I am not in a position to offer proof. What I need for you to do is go to Castle Necromogon and find that parcel of letters or any other information about her activities there. Minnesera will be returning in 13 days. You cannot have any more time than that, I fear. Good luck.
Well, that is intriguing. And that will give us something very interesting to do next time. But for now, I suppose we are done. And hopefully, no ears heard that conversation that shouldn't have.
Good day to you, Nazeem.
Anything else you have to say?
Queen Aubk-i seems more than happy lately. She seems almost relieved.
Yeah, well. Okay, so that'll do it for today then. Thank you so much for watching. Please do like the video if you enjoyed it, subscribe to see more, and consider supporting me at patreon.com/thedrake, where you support not only my video-making shenanigans, but also my indie game development projects under the name of Golden Drake Studios. But whether you can support me or not, thank you so much for being one of my viewers, and I hope you have an excellent day. Be good to yourself and everyone around you. I will see you next time.